कंपनी के नंबर्स कैसे हैं और आगे क्या है आउटलुक, ये जानने के लिए चलते हैं सीधे कंपनी के सीएफओ रोहित गुप्ता हमारे साथ शो में जुड़ रहे हैं। मिस्टर गुप्ता, गुड आफ्टरनून, शुक्रिया हमें समय देने के लिए। सर, पहले तो नंबर्स पर आपका ओवरऑल व्यू, ये क्वार्टर अच्छा दिखा, एड रेवेन्यू इज बैक विद द बैंक सर, विद अ ग्रोथ ऑफ ऑलमोस्ट 20% ईयर ऑन ईयर। कौन से स्पेस या सेक्टर में आपने सबसे ज्यादा ग्रोथ देखी सर, और मैक्सिमम एड रेवेन्यू कहाँ से आपको दिखा है, आउटलुक क्या रहेगा फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ FY22?
Thank you. Before we discuss company's performance, I would just like to talk about an update on the corporate development matters. So, as you know, हमें in principle approval मिल गया अपने board of directors से on Zee Sony merger. We have started the due diligence process and the same is going on presently. We remain confident that the process will get completed within the stipulated timelines and we will move forward as per the applicable regulatory steps. On
Sure.
one matter, which is relating to Invesco, the company has made necessary disclosures to the stock exchange from time to time. And since the matter is currently sub judice, I would not like to state anything further on the same. Now, moving to the performance during the quarter, like you rightly said, we have seen a steady growth in viewership and revenue numbers, and this is attributed to both upswing in the consumer sentiment and spending. So, हमारा advertising revenue जो है वो grow किया है 17.6% sequentially and 20.7% year on year. जो हमारा subscription revenue है वो that stands at 7885 million and it is marginally lower on a year-on-year basis. इसका एक reason भी ये है कि NTO 2.0, which was earlier, planned to be implemented, has now got deferred. So, as per the latest communication from TRAI, the revised implementation date is April 1, 2022. During the quarter, हमारा television network share भी improve हुआ है 70 basis points से. So, our share is now 70.7%. And as far as Z5 is concerned, let me say that our global MAUs and DAUs have shown us a very handsome, growth. And global MAUs are now 93.2 million, and global DAUs are 99.3 million, respectively. Our EBITDA for the quarter, jo hai, wo 4121 million hai, and we have a margin of 20.8%. So as we move to the third quarter, there is of course festive season that we are seeing, and there are also relaxation in restrictions across the states. So we are hopeful that advertisers and consumer sentiment will continue to receive a big boost.
Well, आपने बात की सब्सक्रिप्शन रेवेन्यू की, वो लार्जली फ्लैट रहा है इस बार, क्या रहा उसकी खास वजह और क्या की ग्रोथ ड्राइवर रहेंगे यहाँ पर फॉर फ्यूचर सर?
सो हमारी जो स्ट्रेटजी है वो ये रही है कि एक तो आप देखिए जैसे एड रेवेन्यू इंक्रीज होता है, वी हैव एन एक्सपेंशन इन द मार्जिन्स. And that is one. But at the same time, we have continued to invest in both content and marketing and technology. So this quarter, we have launched more than 30 plus shows. We have based on that, we have increased our market share as well. Kuch hame Q2 mein advantage mila hai, and we expect that H2 mein baki hame advantage milega. We will continue to invest in other shows as well. We obviously have a very prudent way of spending, and we keep our costs tightly under control, and we keep a very keen eye on the margins.
Well, एक इंटरेस्टिंग चीज देखी सर, आपने मार्जिन्स मेंटेन किए हैं, तो व्हाट वाज द बिग रीजन फॉर दैट? क्योंकि जो स्ट्रेटजी आपने अडॉप्ट की क्लियरली दैट हैज वर्क, तो क्या मार्जिन मेंटेन आप किस वजह से कर पाए और आगे मार्जिन पर क्या आउटलुक है फॉर द इंटायर FY22?
So, the second quarter, we witnessed a swift recovery in advertising revenues. And like I said, there has been ease in restrictions across the country. We feel that our revenue in H2, ad revenue in H2 will grow with boost in consumer sentiment and also the festive season. So H2, we expect to grow both over FY20 and FY21. And that said, it will increase in ad revenues will help us in our margin expansion as well. However, at the same time, we are also investing in both in content and marketing. And we have a number of shows that we have launched in Q2. Similar number of shows will be launched in Q3 and in entire H2. So, you know, we expect the margins, you know, to remain at the same level. However, we will be able to give you a better guidance at the end of Q3.
Right. So, आपने कहा try ने defer किया है NTO 2.0 implementation for 3 months. अब ये April 1st, 2022 से शुरू होगा. आपका क्या view है और आपको क्या लगता है इससे company पर क्या impact होगा?
See, जैसे हमने पहले भी बताया, implementation of NTO 2.0, you know, will be ultimately beneficial for the company, and there may be a disruption for the quarter or two. But once it settles, you know, we are confident that we will revert to the subscription growth that we have seen in the past. So we have announced the pricing, and you know, the pricing structure will deliver high value to our consumers by offering unlimited entertainment via both a la carte and bouquet offerings. And we are also providing multiple bouquets to consumers across the country at different price points. However, you know, there is a latest communication from TRAI based on which they have allowed you know, broadcasters to publish their RIOs by 31st December. And the revised implementation date is also now pushed to 1st April 2022. So the impact of implementation will be felt now in the first quarters of FY22.
Sir, Z5 monthly active user base, agar hum dekhe, toh that's gone up by 1.3 crores to 9.32 crores on a quarter-on-quarter basis. That's actually a bahut badhiya achievement humne dekha hai. Kya wajah thi, sir, iski, aur subscription growth yahan par kaisi thi? Kya hai outlook for the company in the OTT space, sir?
So, you know, our strategy in Z5 is playing out very well. And we continue to focus on content. We continue to focus on consumer experience. Both these things are working well for us. This quarter, if you see, our growth in revenue is 17.7%. And our global MAUs are, like I said, 93.2 million. And DAUs are 9.3 million. So we are seeing a very handsome growth in both active users and in revenue. So we will continue to focus on good content. We launched, you know, Radhe in quarter one and Friends Reunion. Then we launched Sunflower, State of Stage 2. So these are some of the shows that, you know, we have been launching 13 plus originals in this quarter. We will continue to, you know, launch content about 17 to 18 shows in quarter three as well, you know, and then, of course, in quarter four, similar shows in quarter four. So the idea is to have a, you know, good consumer experience. And of course, this will result into, you know, revenue growth, you know.
Sir, ek aur interesting cheez is baar dekhi gayi hai, aapka jo network share hai, that's again reaching close to 18%. Aapne kaha, content pipeline kaisi dikh rahi hai aage? What is the lineup for the next few months? Cinemas obviously khul rahe across many states. So how is this content pipeline looking like over the next few months and for the rest of the year, sir?
So, like I said, you know, our network share improved on the back of, you know, 30 plus shows that we launched in this quarter. And it is our endeavor that we will launch similar number of shows in quarter three and quarter four as well. The shows that we launched this quarter was, you know, some of them were like Z Comedy Factory and Survivors in Z Tamil. And we have a very solid slate that we are going to launch in H2 as well. So yes, we are working towards share gain, and share gain will be based on new launches coming from our side.
All right, Mr. Gupta, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया हमसे बात करने के लिए, हमें समय देने के लिए और बताने के लिए कंपनी के आगे के क्या है plans.